I would like to to read from the chapter Jacobo, Yayo, and Quique. I was very surprised when I was doing the research how many insurrections there were with the slaves, and this is just three men and their experience. The two men Severo had brought from San Bernabe slept in hammocks on either side of Jacobo in the men's barracks. Their women still lived on the farm, and Yayo and Quique were anxious about them and their daughters, now at the mercy of Don Luis and Santos, the overseer. Both Yayo and Quique had children and grandchildren conceived in the rapes Don Luis inflicted on their women. Over the years, both men's anger had been stifled, but not smothered. Locked in barracks after lights out in Hacienda Los Gemelos, they could express their anxiety over their families only in low-voiced outrage that mushroomed into frustration and finally to rebellion. At first, Jacobo pretended he didn't hear them, but pretty soon he was listening to their plans. They agreed that the best time to run away would be during the Zafra, when they'd be outdoors with machetes and other tools that could be used as weapons. Folly grows from desperation. Yayo and Quique conspired, and their passion convinced Jacobo to join them. In late 1864, the three men were not in their first youth, but did have experience of the rhythms of the harvest. The coming harvest would begin on the east, northeast, and southeast fields, closest to the border with San Bernabe and the main road to Juarez. Between them and the town was La Palanca, the hamlet of campesinos. Only women and children would be in the village, since the men would be working in the ingenio. They expected no challenge when going through. They might even be able to steal a couple of horses or mules for their getaway into the mountains. They didn't think what might happen if their plan was discovered. They didn't think of the consequences of failure. They didn't think that the two young men who tried to run away from San Bernabe soon after news of the Emancipation Proclamation were whipped to death after they were caught. They didn't think that if they were successful, they'd have to hide for the rest of their lives, moving from cave to cave through the rough terrain of the central mountain range of the island, pursued by hounds, soldiers, and a death sentence. Jacobo knew that if he informed on the other two and it was proved they were conspirators, he would be freed. But he didn't say a word to anyone, and along with Yayo and Quique, began to count moons to make their getaway on a dark night. They settled on the third new moon after the beginning of the harvest the following spring.